I grew up working with my father in his automotive service centers in Toronto called GB Autos. I spent a lot of time in the back with technicians, and at the age of about 15, I started to realize that the rate of which electronics were being embedded into vehicles far surpassed the rate at which mechanics were actually learning about how this technology worked. If you go to my father's shop or any dealerships around here, their tools have been around for about 20 years, right? So things don't change very much there. And very rarely do you find a group of brilliant engineers wanting to work on problems for mechanics. And so I think that's what it comes down to. So how does it work? So basically it pulls information from the onboard computers of the car. We get a lot of information from the manufacturers, like Ford, for example, as well as from the dealership. So we can see how mechanics have fixed cars in the past. So when we correlate all that information, we can suggest to you, hey, we've seen 5,000 Ford Focuses with this specific fuel pump issue at this mileage, at this time of year, based on the same driving patterns. And we can suggest to you that, hey, there's a 90% chance that you will have this fuel pump problem in the next 500 kilometers. And so it's in your best interest to at least be aware of it, if not go in and get it serviced. So it's very big data and machine learning approach where we could actually detect a body control module was short circuiting. So if the customer didn't stop the car, it would have led to a fire inside the dashboard of the vehicle. So it's like some very interesting correlations that can be made by simply looking at data that's very accessible on the vehicle. We literally can take these vehicles and make them think for themselves. There's just all this traffic on the road, there's stoplights, like we can actually improve the efficiency. So instead of just everyone just buying more and more cars, there's 300 million cars in North America alone. Look at our infrastructure and make it more efficient. We can't keep building roads. We gotta make the way we travel more effective. That makes things so much smarter. And I think that's the future that we wanna be a part of. GM is actually at the forefront of pushing forward this connected car. They've always had OnStar, so they've always been innovators on that side of things. They're really pushing the headway on how auto manufacturers should be looking at this space. It gives startups and young companies a chance to really show that our software is actually far more valuable than you have ever thought of in the past. And they're helping lead and pave the way for other manufacturers to really realize that, hey, we need to start looking into software companies like PitStop. So I think GM is incredible for doing that, and them being in this region is extremely intelligent.